Dear all, today we'll see how to restrict the activities on different criteria, right? So there may be the profile activity, means profile based restriction. There may be some activity restriction. We'll see that in this demo course. So this is our demo course. Now I want to restrict certificate to the students on course exit survey. So it student should submit the course exit survey, fill the course exit survey, and then and only then that certificate will get generated, right? So on this activity I want to restrict this activity, or you can restrict to the students by their roll number, by their first name, last name. So there are a number of criteria, so we'll see here how you can restrict such activities, right? So for that you need to click on turn editing on. Now here we have already some activities. Now here you see here we have some blocks, right? So this is the block, square block, here square block. So this is what here another block is there, course exit survey. So you see this block is a dotted block and this block is not a dotted block, right? So the difference is this. So this is a directly student can click here and make this activity as a complete. So you read this, student can manually mark this item as a complete, right? But you see this, the system marks this item complete according to the condition set. So here we need to set some condition to complete this activity. So already I have done this, but I'll show you how these conditions can be set. So click on edit setting and expand all, and you see here completion, when this activity will be complete, right? So activity completion, there are three criteria. One is do not indicate this activity submission completion, so there will not be any square bracket in front of any activity, or student can manually mark this activity as complete. So without seeing that activity, student can also tick there and say that key, this activity is completed by me. So this is what generally only clicking on that activity. And here third activity is there, show activity as complete when some conditions are met. So here we have some conditions, it depends on the activity these conditions are getting displayed. So this is the feedback activity, so course exit survey. So when this activity will be completed, so I have meant the condition student must view this activity to complete it. And another condition is there, view as complete if the feedback is submitted. So this is a very important, student should submit the feedback and then only this activity will be completed. So for the third option, that square bracket will be dotted. Now save this and display. I'll go to the course page. So you see here, this is the course exit survey, and in front of this dotted block. So dotted block itself says that there are some conditions, right? And that condition already seen. Now on this activity, we want to restrict some certificate. So when that certificate will be generated, after be giving the feedback, right? Or any other activity also you can restrict. So I'll show you how we can restrict certificate, right? So click on edit setting, edit setting, and click on expand all. Now we have to restrict this activity. So here we have a restriction criteria, so click here all restriction, and here we have a different criteria. On that on this criteria you can restrict that this activity. So here I want to restrict on another activity. You can restrict on date as well, you can restrict on some grades, you can restrict to that particular group, or you can restrict depend on the username, depend on the role number and some user profile fields. So I want to restrict on activity completion. So here you see I have chosen the activity completion. So which activity? So whatever the activity in the course that will be shown to you here. So one is label experiment one. Here we have a course exit survey, here we have a certificate and attendance. These are what some activities. So I want to make it on course exit survey. So this course exit survey should be marked complete, and then only this activity will be available for the students. So see here, I have given the criteria. You can add another criteria also on another activity also. For example, I will another activity as for example experiment number one. So if that experiment one activity gets complete, then and then only. So both activity should be complete, or here you can say any of this activity, but only we'll concentrate on one activity. So I'll remove this condition and I want to see only on course exit survey, right? So I will click on save and return to the course. So you see here, restricted, not available unless the activity course exit survey is marked. So when this certificate will be available for students, when they submit the course exit survey, right? So they should submit the course exit survey, and then only this activity will be available for the student. Now what we'll do, we'll see by a student role. So we'll log out from this and we'll log in by student role, right? So here I have a student, so I'll choose student login. And see, this is the student login. I'll select the course, and now you see when student get logins to this page, this course. Now this, you see here, no clickable, this hand button will be appear here. It says restricted, not available unless the activity course exit survey is marked complete. So here we have a course exit survey, it's a conditional, or if it is there, you can just click this activity gets complete, right? But you see here, no clickable, no action. So we should give the feedback, so students should submit the feedback and view this activity. So answer the questions, and say these are the compulsory questions. So I'll directly give random feedback, and this is not a compulsory, so I'll write some NA or keep blank, submit. When I submit, it says me thank you, okay, and I'll say continue. So I'll visit. Now you see I have given this feedback, right? So it gets tick. So this activity got completed, and immediately after completing this, that condition got removed and this certificate is available now. So when I click on this, the certificate will be generated for me. Can see the certificate. So this is the way, so certificate get displayed, downloaded, and again visit. So this is the way to restrict some activities on different criterias, right? Now you can visit our teacher login. So this is the way to restrict some activities on some different profile or some different criterias. So okay, you can visit your course page by your okay. And you can see we have received certificate. So certificate received information will be shown to you when it is awarded and what is the code of this, and you can also download this certificate. So this is the way to restrict some activities. Okay, thanks for watching this video. If any query, you can directly ask me in our comment section. Thanks.